terrible. She would be ashamed of herself.
You can talk after those photographs of you and Dave at the Christmas party.
That's history, all right?
I'll have you know, I've had quite a few requests to include those photographs in the first edition of the Sunny Hill newspaper.
You're doing it to be the last edition.
Oh, yeah. Can I take that as a threat to the freedom of the press?
No. Just its editor.
Yeah, well, point taken, Tony. Sarge. Oh, Sarge?
Yeah.
Do you know if Viv Marcella's in today?
She's down at Child Protection. She'll be back later.
Oh, yeah, because I'd like her to do something on my newspaper.
Page 3, is it?
Hello, I'm Vanessa Bowman. Hello, through here. This is Mrs. Sarah Gibbs and Josie Gibbs.
Hello, I'm a sergeant with the Child Protection Team. Has Viv explained why?
She told us in the car.
Josie?
Yeah. Now, I'll be asking you some questions today, but Viv will be dealing with the case, okay? Are you listening to her, Josie? No. Can you tell us, in your own words, exactly what happened? Josie wants to be a model. She's serious about it. So for her birthday, I said I'd get her a portfolio of photos done professionally. And I took her to this photographer, Don Sutton.
Oh, when was your birthday?
Last month.
And how old were you?
14.
I took her there for 3 sessions. They did some lovely photos. Then yesterday, she went there again. I was at work. I knew when I got home something wasn't right.
Sarah, I realise it isn't easy for either of you, but it is important that Josie tells us what happened at the studio herself.
He asked me over yesterday afternoon to do some pictures. There were some swimsuits all laid out, and he asked me to model them. I was getting changed, and he grabbed hold of me. He asked me to do things.
And what did he say?
He wanted me to have sex.
He threatened you, didn't he?
He said I had to. He was feeling me up.
And where did he touch you?
Here.
Did he do it with one hand or with both?
One, I think.
And which hand?
It was both.
Are you sure?
Then she pushed him off and ran out.
And your clothes?
I picked them up.
I've just got to get this straight in my own mind, Josie. Let's go back a bit. You were taking off your clothes.
She's told you, hasn't she?
Before we go on, shall we have a cup of tea? Sarah, can you give me a hand?
That's the worst bit over. You done a lot of modelling?
Since I was a little kid. It's what my mum wants.
And you?
It's a good career, isn't it? Money, travel. They can work all over the world.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Your mother's been told very politely to shut up.
I'd just like to go through it all again in a bit more detail.
So is this a waste of time?
Something happened to her.
I bet most of them regret it now.
Afternoon, sir. Madam?
Don Sutton.
A wedding, is it? Mr. Sutton's not available at the moment. Perhaps I can help.
D.S. Roach, D.C. Martella from Sunhill Police.
You won't want to look at the sample albums then, will you?
No. Could you please tell Mr. Sutton we'd like to talk to him?
Dad?
He's in the print room.
Don Sutton?
Oh, he doesn't just do weddings.
DC Martella from Sunhill CID. I'd like to ask you some questions.
Far away.
We're investigating an allegation of indecent assault made by a girl called Josie Gibbs.
Who's assaulted her?
She says you assaulted her yesterday.
Josie? She's been here for weeks, has she, Julian?
Wait a minute. You can't just come in here and accuse him of something like that.
Could we talk about this alone, please, Mr. Sutton?
Give them half a chance. They'll have you saying you did it. Don't say anything. I'm phoning a solicitor.
Doc, it's just got to be a mistake.
Stay chewing. It's not worth the risk.
Julian! I'm sorry. He's a bit hasty.
I'm not arresting you, but I must warn you that anything you say may be given in evidence.
There's no need for that, darling.
I'll tell you what I know.
Did Josie Gibbs come here yesterday afternoon?
No. I was here by myself.
That's not what she says.
Look, I've been a photographer for 30 years, yeah? With models a lot better looking than her, I can tell you. There've been plenty of opportunities. And yeah, I've taken some of them, perks at the job. But I have never gone for little girls.
She says she came here to your studio at 2:30 yesterday afternoon.
If people start believing I'll touch up teenage girls, I might as well close up shop for good. They won't want me doing the weddings. They won't even want me doing the flipping passports.
Were you here yesterday afternoon?
The truth is, love, I'd had a few at lunchtime and I came back here to sleep it off. So I was here, but I was out of it.
Has she ever come here by herself?
Her mother always brought her. Hey, she's another reason for keeping your hands well off the merchandise. Have you met her? Have you? Her mother, she's ruthless the way she pushes that kid. And of course, then there is the little matter of the money she owes me. At least 200 quid.
Have you got proof of this?
We just sent her another invoice. And now she comes out with this old cock and bull story.
Hello? Can I help you?
I'd like to speak to Viv. Viv Martella.
Is she expecting you?
No. She knows who I am.
What's your name, huh?
Josie Gibbs.
I've seen you somewhere before.
I don't think he laid a finger on her.
He smelt like a saloon bar carpet. Gotta be a serious boozer. He could have been out of his brain yesterday afternoon, touched up Josie and not remember a thing about it today.
Yeah, he could have been. We don't know. The CPS won't give him his house room.
CID Martella speaking.
Put money on it.
All right. OK, thanks, Reg. It's Josie. She's downstairs.
She gonna make her day?
Don't hold your breath.
Do you ever go in the Red Line?
No.
I'll get it in a minute. I'll never forget a face.
Hello, Josie.
I need to talk to you.
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Ridge. This way.
I'm sorry.
About?
I'm not supposed to come here. I have to talk to someone.
I don't know if I'm the right person if it's just a chat, Josie.
Please, it's important.
Does your mother know you're here?
No. I don't want her to know. But I had to tell you. What I told you, it isn't true.
Oh. Got something for Vivia?
She's out.
Yeah, well, just leave it for her then. Will you do me a favour? Say page 48 to her, she know what I mean.
48?
Yeah, 48.
Hollis, get out.
Come on, let's get this over with.
Where have you been?
Josie came to see me about the allegation.
Well, what's the street going to think, seeing you dragged home by the police?
Could we come in and talk about this calmly, please?
I won't have you sneaking off like that. Anything could have happened. Come in here.
Thanks. Josie's told me she's been lying.
Mum, I'm sorry.
What do you mean, lying?
It didn't happen. He didn't do anything.
She's saying that no assault took place.
I know what she's saying.
I made it up, I'm sorry.
You're sorry, are you? Do you know how this makes me look? I don't know what you must think of me.
I'm not blaming you.
Don Sutton could have done so much for you. What's he gonna think now? You can go upstairs to your room, I'll talk to you later.
Wait a minute.
Do as you're told.
Did you put pressure on Josie to make her change her story?
Why should I?
Well, don't you think it's a bit odd that she should suddenly change her mind?
Don Sutton took such trouble over those pictures.
Is it true that you haven't paid for them?
And what's that got to do with it? I'll be paying him as soon as Josie gets some work. That chance of that now, when word gets around about this.
She told me the reason she made the story up was because she didn't like the sort of work you'd been getting her. Topless work. I mean, she's still a child.
I had noticed. She doesn't do anything you wouldn't see on any beach in the summer.
Well, wouldn't it be best to talk to her about that?
I'll talk to her, all right. I've managed for the last 14 years, keeping the house, my job, Josie. Hasn't been easy, but I've done it on my own. What gives you the right to barge in here and tell me what's for the best?
I've explained to Josie that making false allegations about people is a very serious matter, Mrs. Gibbs.
I know, I can see that.
I'll need a statement from her withdrawing the allegation about Sutton.
If that's all you want, then I don't need to waste any more of your time.
You got any news?
News?
Yeah, Reg Hollis asked me to write something for his paper.
And you agreed?
Yeah, well, he cornered me in the canteen, didn't he, eh? Hey, there's terrible choice. Sacrifice half a plate of chips, or be lumbered with writing news from CID.
Well, you know what they say. Make it snappy, make it grabby, make it up.
You never guess what she's done. She's only withdrawn the allegation.
Josie?
Yeah, she's been telling a pack of lies. It's just her little war with the world's worst mother.
So Sutton was telling the truth.
All right, all right. Don't look so smug about it.
Ray Collis left that for you.
All right, thanks. Jeez. Very funny, Reg. Well, if this is his idea of a joke.
Well, it did say page 48.
Ted, I don't know if you realise, but my sense of humour is wearing a bit thin.
She's not leaving much to the imagination.
Page 48.
It's Josie. You wait till I get my hands on her. Who took the pictures?
It's got to be Sutton.
Is that what Josie says?
She won't speak to me. She won't even look at them.
Where is she?
In the kitchen.
Josie! Josie! She's not in here.
As soon as my back is turned.
What about upstairs?
There you are. I've got brand new copies of my own. Compliments to the publisher.
Right, you can borrow this one.
I don't think the magistrate would be too impressed with a condition of yours. Might wonder where it's been.
What magistrate?
The one who's given the ruling on whether those pictures are indecent.
Does it look like she's taken anything?
No. I thought I could trust her. Really, I did.
Does she have any money?
Well, there might be some in here.
Has she taken some of it?
I don't even know where this came from.
Come in.
DS Road, Sunhill CID.
Oh, yes. Some photos for me to look at.
This is the magazine. It's already marked, therefore. These are the unpublished negs, straight from the publisher.
How old is she?
14.
What was the coercion?
We haven't established that yet.
Well, the published photographs are borderline, but some of these others I definitely see were indecent. You have grounds for prosecution there. You happy?
Thank you for seeing me at such short notice.
Of course, I have a completely free hand in my editorial capacity. But since the newspaper is going to be speaking for the entire division, Mr. Brownlow has agreed to give me his advice, you know, on any potentially sensitive items.
So you're showing him your sensitive items, are you, Reg?
Sounds like censorship to me.
No, George, you got it all wrong, mate. Oh, no sugar.
So this is the sort of paper Reg is really interested in, eh?
Yeah, I'll give it to him.
Well, not you as well.
No.
Now, look, if either of you have got an idea for a title, feel free, right? Because I'm open to suggestions.
How about The Sunhill Sun?
Now, do you know you might have something there? Yeah, I can see it now. The Sunhill Sun says...
The only photographs of Josie I took, her mother's gone. Search the studio if you don't believe me.
Is this invoice from your studio?
Looks like it.
Is it?
Yes.
This invoice was sent to Priapix Publications along with these negatives of Josie Gibbs. Would you care to look at them?
Can I speak to my solicitor? If you need to. Interview suspended, 16:45. We'll be outside when you're ready. He's gonna cough. He took one look at those negs and he went.
Talk about a double take.
Yeah, he didn't know we had them. They were obviously taken by him in a studio.
No, it wasn't just that. It was almost like he saw something when he looked at them. These weren't taken in a studio. Look at these ones at the end.
Okay, so the one taken in the studio.
Yeah, she's in a house or a flat.
We're gonna look at her background.
My client is ready to talk to you.
As far as I can see, Reg Hollis is writing the old paper himself.
Quite sensible, he's the only one who's gonna read it.
Tier 1 from Sierra Oscar.
Cheer us up, Kath.
Disturbance reported at Sutton's Photographic Studio, Heath Place.
We're at the right end of the ground for a change. We're on our way. First left turn.
Interview resumed, 16:48, those present as before. Now, I'm going to ask you again, Mr. Sutton. Did you take these photos of Josie?
Yes, I did.
All right, when did you take them?
Last month.
Can you be more specific?
It was when her mother brought her along.
Her mother was there when you took them?
Yes. I suppose so.
Her mother consented to her stripping off and posing like that.
I took the pictures, all right? You want to know about what her mother thinks? Ask her.
So you're telling me that you took those photos with the consent of Josie and her mother? Do you expect me to believe that?
Do you think it doesn't happen all the time?
You tell me.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra One. We're at Heath Place now, over. Okay, can you stand back, please, thanks. Thank you.
Must have been a great party.
Smashing. Sounds like it's still going on.
Dave! Up here.
Five more minutes, I would have been out of that office and into the pub. Perfect timing.
Come on, calm down, that's enough.
She's gone mad. She's completely lost it.
Let's go downstairs and talk about it, all right? Just calm down.
Okay, love, look, open the door. It's the police.
What's your name?
Julian Sutton. It's my place.
So what's this all about?
I'm working in the darkroom and I hear some noise. And she's trashing the place.
We weren't expecting backup.
We weren't expecting this.
Girl's upstairs, throwing a wobbly.
It's not the only thing she's thrown.
Is it Josie?
Have you seen what she's done to this place?
Little bitch needs locking up.
Come on. I can't get her to open the door.
Josie, it's me, Viv Martella. Look, it's all right now. Just let us in, yeah?
Sierra Oscar from 340 receiving.
Receiving.
Do you want to tell me what happened, Josie?
Yeah, I need an ambulance at Heath Place, over.
I had to know why he'd done it. Put those pictures in the magazine.
Julian.
He said they were just for him. Just so he could have them when I wasn't here. He never said nothing about a magazine.
Julian took the photos.
He was so nice to me. I used to bunk off school and come here.
He took them in here, didn't he?
I thought it was just me. But he does it all the time. I found them downstairs. All those pictures of girls. He told me he only used me because I was cheap.
Charming. And he did that to you.
Viv, the ambulance is coming.
Thanks, Dave.
I can't go home. She said she never wanted to see me again.
Come on, let's get you downstairs.
Real hard man, aren't you? You get off on beating up little girls.
I didn't mean to hurt her.
Cobblers.
I had to do something.
Look what she's done. Do you know how much all these lights cost?
Why did she do it?
There's nothing I've done. We had a business arrangement. She got paid well, and she couldn't leave it at that.
You took the photos?
So?
Julian Sutton, I'm cautioning you. You don't have to say anything unless you wish to do so. But anything you do say may be given in evidence.
You're not gonna do me for taking a few pictures.
She's a child and the pictures are indecent.
Up to a couple of minutes ago, we were going to charge your old man. He told us he took them.
Yeah, he would, wouldn't he?
Why is that?
I keep this place going. There's so little blood in his alcohol stream these days that he doesn't just get camera shake. It's more like camera rattle. Anything happens to me, he can kiss goodbye to his precious business.
So you keep the place going by taking mucky pictures of little girls?
And you never look at them? You never buy the mags they're in? Someone does, because I could sell every photo I do 3 times over. If it's what they want, where's the arm? Oh, you pleased with yourself, you silly little cow?
I'm warning you.
You see what you've done? She liked doing it. She got off on it and she got the going rate.
You seen what you've done to her? You're going to get well over the going rate from the salt like that. Now, come on.
Come in.
Hollis is here, sir. The appointment we moved from last week.
I think I preferred him when he was Federation rep. He was up here less often.
How long before the urgent phone call?
Well, if you leave it for more than 3 minutes, I'm going to find some very urgent typing that needs doing before you go home, all right?
Right. You can go in now.
Very nice of you to see me, sir.
All right, Hollis. Take a seat, will you? Oh, thank you.
I just wanted you to see the way my mind is working. It's a bit rough at the moment, but, I'll give you an idea.
Full-colour printing. Rather ambitious, don't you think?
Not more questions.
I just came to see how she was.
I've done the stitches. There's going to be a scar.
I'm sorry.
I thought I'd only made 2 real mistakes in my life. The first one was falling for a boy who cleared off after a fortnight. The second one was leaving it too late when I found out I was pregnant. I thought it was going to be so different for Josie, so much better, because I was there to stop her making the same mistakes.
She got involved with a very nasty piece of work.
Sitting at home this afternoon, waiting for her, not knowing where she was, I realised that if I'd lost her, that's all I'd have had left. That's all we've managed, her and me. Those pictures. I never want her to have to do that again.
You know that now.
After the way she's been slapped around, she won't be able to anyway. Stupid, isn't it?
People are. And you end up learning the hard way.